the second iteration of our SA 360 webinar summer series. Today is again part two, where we will be focusing on leveraging advanced automation in management. So looking at some bidding strategies and some other really cool stuff that can save you a lot of time and money by making the most of the technology that's available to you. So a couple of quick things to note. We recently moved into a new space and some of the building is still going up. So if the acoustics sound a little bit weird when Bailey starts talking, apologies. Likewise, if you hear any weird construction noises in the background, we're hoping that's ceased for a while. But if on the off chance you do hear anything and need her to repeat anything, please feel free to just ping us in the chat box and we can go back over anything. Again, hoping that's not an issue, but just wanted to call that out. And then last but not least, before I kick it over to her, just want to confirm that like last time, this is being recorded and I will be sharing out that video as well as the full deck following the webinar. So for those of you who are interested in following up or want to share with colleagues, absolutely feel free to do so. So with that in mind, I will kick it over to Bailey to get started.
Thanks, Liz. Hi, everybody. Welcome to today's webinar. My name is Bailey Templin. For those of you who were not in attendance last time, I'm a senior account manager here at Jellyfish. I've been working in the Search Ads 360 platform for a little over 4.5 years now. And like Liz mentioned, it's the second iteration of our summer series. So we first worked through advanced attribution, and now we're taking it one step further and going through automation. So like you mentioned, if there's any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat box. If you do have any client-specific questions or account-specific questions, it's probably best to email your account team afterwards. Our goal here is to really use this as a thought starter. So like I said, today's presentation should hopefully guide a lot of the strategic opportunities moving forward. But if they're more general or any kind of general commentary, feel free to drop it in the chat box and I will answer as many questions as time for allows. So just a brief overview for anyone who either attended last session or was not able to make it. We talked about advanced attribution modeling. So our main goal there, key takeaway, was to remember ideally for the 99 percentile, non-last click attribution is normally the best, being able to take into account multiple touch points in the digital path to conversion. If you are using Campaign Manager, there is options for custom attribution modeling available in there. Those are for more advanced advertisers, including like impression-based media. But if that is an opportunity for your business, please feel free to reach out to your account team. And like I mentioned before, having the different attribution models in place, now you can really leverage them in automation in areas like bid strategies, which we'll get to. But again, the takeaways from last time are really how to leverage that technology as we move forward. And just a brief agenda for today, like I mentioned, it's pretty similar to last time. We're gonna go through the goals and objectives of today's session. What do we want you to get out of it? Different sources of automation within the SA 360 platform, how to actually set up and implement any of these strategies and opportunities we talked through, as well as learnings and next steps and what we're, you know, aiming for you to get out of it. So first and foremost, goals and objectives. Obviously, we're all very thankful you guys are here attending today's session, but what do we really want you to get out of it? Really, what we want you to do is really help alleviate any unnecessary manual management, be it bidding, you know, activating ad copy, things like that, freeing up those hours to really focus on strategic, larger opportunities. Because you are paying for the enterprise technology, you're using it in some way, shape, or form. Make sure you're using it to its fullest potential. And like I said, why is this important? Like we said, you're paying for the technology, but technology right now is at an all-time high. We want to make sure that the hours we're spending on daily tasks are going to the most prevalent opportunities. Your time is valuable. Spend it where it makes the most impact for your business. Allow the data and algorithm to drive decision-making process like bidding, which can be handled through a computer and algorithm with just as much, if not even stronger, capabilities than a human. So now that we have the goals and objectives out of the way, what are some of the sources of automation within Search Ads 360? So the main key areas we're going to talk about today, Bid strategies is going to be a huge focus for us just because that is one of the largest drivers of automation. So we'll kind of talk through the different strategies available within Search Ads 360, as well as different opportunities that are available strictly from the SA360 platform versus just standard engine level strategies. On the left-hand side of this slide, you'll see six main strategies. If you've been pretty heavily kind of working in platform, you're probably pretty familiar, but for those of you who are not, just a general overview. So conversions would be if you have a conversion-based goal, maybe you're focusing on a CPA target, you can set a conversion strategy to handle this type of initiative. Revenue would be if you're focusing on an ROAS or an ROI, so return on ad spend or investment model. Advanced targeting would be if you need kind of two different targets. So you could have a CPA goal tied with the ROAS goal if you needed. Those ones, again, take a little bit more time to set up, but they are available if you have multiple metrics you need to focus upon. Click models would be for those who are focusing on traffic. I would say for the most part, they're not the most used just because, again, they don't really have a conversion point behind them. The goal is to get you traffic. But if you are focused on, you know, getting people into a remarketing pool or really driving just overall consumer demand, a click-based strategy might be good for you. Impression share. So that is actually a newer one that just rolled out of beta on the last few weeks. For those of you who are not aware, as of August 15th, Google will be deprecating the keyword positional model. So because they are getting rid of their average position metric, I'm sure it's been relayed to all of you, but just kind of as a reminder, as that gets deprecated, the keyword positional strategy will not be utilized anymore for Google campaigns. So for anybody who is utilizing keyword positional strategies on Google right now, before August 15th, it is best for you to manually migrate those campaigns over to an impression share strategy. So impression share strategies can be top of page, on the page, and absolute top of page, and the percentage you're willing to spend as well as the max bid. It does take you step by step directionally in the platform if you are choosing to run. But again, if you are running keyword positional at this time, please make sure that you are planning to migrate. There are, again, some campaigns that can be automatically migrated, but for personal, just, you know, comfort, it's easier to have someone actually making the change versus relying 100% on the system. Kind of going into keyword positional, I know it's not on here, but your Bing campaigns or other engines can still run in keyword positional following August 15th. That would be, again, off of average position or what kind of positional constraints you're willing to stay within. But again, it will no longer be applicable within Google as of August 15th. And last but not least, budget fit strategies. So for those of you who have seen the beta budget management in the left-hand navigation, there is now an option to take your budget plans into a bid strategy. So once you have your campaigns grouped in the initial budget group settings, budget plans can then either be utilized strictly for planning, or you can take it one step further by selecting and checking that box and allowing the system to handle your budgeting as well as KPIs for that specific time frame. Key note here, obviously, again, these are newer, but it is 100% a hands-off model in the sense that the system's going to handle both the budgeting and the day-to-day conversions, but it is available. And if you are interested in testing, more than happy to send across information for everyone on the line. Lastly, to close off the overall bid strategy section, tying back into our last section, automation can be leveraged across multiple attribution modeling. So if you did create those additional floodlight attribution models, in this case, maybe data-driven or linear time decay, here's where you can leverage it. So in your bid strategies, when you're selecting the conversion point, you can select multiple attribution models to allow for that data to be associated with that new strategy. Secondly, now that we've covered off in the main topics, there are some additional biddable adjustments that are available strictly within Search Ads 360 as you kind of leverage enterprise level technology. For me, in my personal experience, I can say this is probably one of the most valuable aspects of automation, just because as a day-to-day manager, it's really hard to find the time to evaluate device, remarketing, and location that are evolving every minute. So what this will do is it will adjust them for you. So device is across both Google and Bing and leveraged across tablet, mobile, and desktop. So what it will do is look at your bid modifiers for different devices and adjust them in the percentages as evaluated every 6 hours or 4 times a day in alignment with the rest of the strategy. Remarketing and location are just within Google, so they're exclusive to the Google platform. But what they will do is adjust your audience percentages for remarketing as well as any location adjustments you have set up. Great. So now we covered, you know, bid strategies, but what other automated features are available within the platform? Rules. I'm hoping that everybody on the line has at least some general rule set up, because I think even for this, the purpose of notification, they're super valuable. So as you're creating bid strategies or just general management, rule of thumb, have a general rule for brand safety. So maybe you need your top 5 keywords and they stop serving impressions, you want to know immediately. Make sure you set a rule that will notify you if something, you know, drops off the map. If you set a bid strategy and for some reason some of your keywords are hitting the floor, you want to be alerted before there's any huge issues. So here's where you can do it. Rules can also be used for aspects such as changing the state of an ad copy or a campaign. You can schedule in advance if it's over a weekend or a holiday. Who wants to be online having to look at it? Now you can use automation in order to handle that for you, send you an alert once it's done, everything's checked off. For those of you using templates, so there is automation within the inventory management templates. What you can do there is utilize either a Google Merchant Center feed and or non-retail feed, pulling through attributes within columns and able to scale campaigns, ad groups, keywords, ad copy, you name it. So that's a really interesting feature. For those of you in the e-com vertical, it's pretty easy to get these set up because you can leverage your Merchant Center feed one-to-one. If you're not, totally fine. There is an opportunity for non-retail feeds as long as you create the feed in a Google Sheet yourself. And again, if this is something you're interested in learning about further, please reach out to your top team. And then last but not least, so business data. Business data, for the most part, are labels, but it's a way to really segment your data and take a look at it from a more slice and dice functionality. But if you do choose to take your business data one step further, it can be used to, you know, change the state of certain campaigns or keywords based upon, you know, inventory and information. So again, these are additional automated features that we aren't going to necessarily cover off on in the setup, but if you do have any questions, your account team is more than willing to help. So now we talked about, you know, the basics. How do you actually set them up in platform? So luckily, bid strategies are really pretty easy to set up. For those of you familiar in the platform, in your left-hand navigation, there's a tab for bid strategies. It's 1 or 2 down. What you'll do is once you enter the bid strategy section, you'll select create a bid strategy. You'll name your strategy and select the currency. Pretty straightforward. The more difficult aspects are really to figure out your goals and the targets. So in this case, when you're thinking about selecting your goals, make sure your goal aligns with your overarching business objective. You want to make sure if you're setting a conversion-based target that your goals somehow align with conversions or CPA. If not, make sure you're adjusting your strategies to associate with the correct goals. And then once your goals are there, define those targets. So within each bid strategy, once you select the goals, the system will preempt you to define your targets. It'll give you what kind of information it needs. You just drop in the, you know, CPA or ROAS value that you're looking to obtain. If it needs any kind of, you know, min and max bid, it'll, you know, prompt you to do so. Enter your targets and then assign your conversion source. Like I mentioned before, pulling the whole summer series back together, look at different attribution modeling. I've seen really great performance with data-driven. Obviously, data-driven is pretty prominent, but if you're using any other attribution modeling, it does not have to be a last click. Consider that when you're setting up a strategy and make sure that when you're optimizing towards your target, you're at least considering other options. What are some additional features within bid strategies? So When you're setting it up, if you're pretty new to strategies and you're not really sure where to start, the bid strategy opportunity section is probably going to be your best bet. You can basically tell the system, here's the conversion goal I'm looking to obtain. It will then provide you with campaigns it believes are most aligned with that goal, and then it kind of guides you into how to set it up. From the event section, these are more once you actually have a strategy in place, but you can either disclose an event. So say for some reason your site went down for a couple of days, this algorithm for the bid strategy is always learning. So you don't want it to learn on quote unquote bad data. So what you can do is basically have the system put on blinders in a sense and say, you know what, I don't want you to look at these like last 4 days because they're not standard procedure. It can then kind of ignore those dates and not adjust anything from an algorithmic long-term perspective. They also did recently roll out what they call seasonality adjustments. So those are if you have a conversion rate shift, usually about 10 to 20% off of your standard, you can tell the system that that's okay. You're expecting to see that. It's not, you know, something you should be concerned about. I'm thinking of it more as an opportunity for retailers come Black Friday, Cyber Monday, when historically we tended to recommend manual bidding. This is going to give an opportunity for the system to continue to automate your bidding despite seeing pretty heavy fluctuations. Thirdly, forecasting. So once you have your different strategies in place, you're able to look at the forecasting tool for aspects like ROAS and conversion. What this will do is basically give you a guide as to how your performance will shift depending on what your new goal is. If you're wanting to see, if I change my ROAS target by 100%, what will that look like in terms of budget? It will tell all of that for you and kind of give you a general guide. That being said, you do normally have to get out of the learning phase for forecasting to be available. But once it is, you'll have that opportunity to really kind of gauge how different changes will impact the long term. And last but not least, auction time bidding. So for anybody on the line who is currently opted into auction time bidding, I'm sure you guys have a general idea, but if you're not, auction time bidding was rolled out at the Google Marketing Summit. What this will do is take floodlight data, push it into Google Ads, and then Google Ads will use that floodlight data in their Google Ads strategies, but look at a bunch more signals that are than are available in a standard strategy. So there are things like time of day that are kind of for, I believe, weather might be one of them. There's a list. But basically what this will do is take into account a greater number of signals when changing the bids. One thing to note here, again, it is available within Google. So if you are running any strategies, they can't be multi-engine for auction time bidding. It's also in whitelist, so if for some reason you're not currently opted in, please hand raise, reach out to your account team. They can get you hand raised if you're interested. But again, the value add here is if you are running a Google Ads strategy within search ads, it just uses floodlight data instead of just strictly Google Ads data. And like we mentioned before, that just means multi-engine and more opportunity to gauge the entire landscape. And last but not least, what are some key considerations when you're creating strategies and like looking at them for implementation? First, are your targets attainable? Yes, in a perfect world, we'd really, really like to see strong targeting, you know, always hitting our goals. But if you set your target way too high, in theory, the system will never be able to learn to that value. And you're actually kind of hurting yourself because in theory, it'll never actually get out of the learning phase. So if you are looking for a higher target than what you currently have, totally fine, but just kind of use it in steps to get up to that final goal versus setting it way too high and letting the system not actually evaluate properly. Secondly, do you meet the minimum number of conversions? So we'll kind of get into learning phase in a little bit, but there are a minimum number of conversions. I believe it's about 20 per month at the bare minimum. This is so that the system can actually make decisions and the data is actually there for it to make proper decisions. If you do not meet the minimum conversion goal, don't fret. There is an opportunity to do micro conversions. So if you are a retailer with a path to conversion, maybe someone who adds to the cart as well as purchased is fine in order to make that final number high enough. But again, it's totally up to your business and what you know is considered a quality lead or quality conversion. But if you don't meet the actual bare minimum for conversions, micro conversions can definitely help boost you to get you there. And last but not least, have you prepared for the necessary learning phase? Unfortunately, it does require to learn. That being said, the learning phase in standard is usually 4 to 6 weeks. It depends again on how much data and conversions you're getting, time of year, et cetera. But make sure you're prepared for that learning phase because it's pretty much a hands-off approach. Once you start and it's in learning phase, manual adjustments will push it back into learning. So just make sure you have preparation for the necessary time frame. So learnings and next steps. So like I mentioned, the learning phase, 4 to 6 weeks on average. It can depend on, again, the size of your client, how much you're spending, the landscape, the data, you know, amounts provided. So don't, you know, quote me, but again, it's usually 4 to 6 weeks on average. When it's in that phase, please try to refrain from making manual changes. The system needs to learn. It's going to try, you know, pushing some keywords to the floor, pushing some to the ceiling, changing bids. As it learns, it's going to fluctuate and it can be a little scary. So full transparency from having worked it on my end, it can be extremely scary. You're seeing some of your top brand terms suddenly dropping, you know, multiple pages. That's why you would want to set rules. So kind of tying rules back in. If you are creating bid strategies, set rules. If you have, you know, brand terms, make sure you get an alert or notification if the position drops, you know, 2 or 3 spots. That's important. Maybe some of your top campaigns stop serving impressions or getting as many clicks. Make a rule. It says if it doesn't get 10 clicks in a day, that's a problem. You'll just get a notification to be able to actually go and guarantee it's a problem. But that being said, you can utilize both automation from the bid strategy and rules perspective to keep your accounts on balance. But once you have it set up, the learning phase has subsided, what's next? First, you'll see a column for percentage of optimal cost. So that's going to be available within the bid strategy section. What this will do is basically tell you how your strategy is performing. In a perfect world, it would be 100%, which means that you're both efficient and effective. There's no inefficiency. You're not spending too much, too little. It's great. That will show as 100%. If it's above or under, or above or under, it just means that there is room to make improvements. So just kind of keep tabs on that column. The bid strategy health. So this is going to be important, especially as you're starting out. It will tell you, maybe you set your min too low, your max bid or budget too high. It's going to let you know. There's a column that says bid strategy health, and it gives you a little symbol, and it'll tell you exactly what the issue is. This will also pinpoint where you might be constrained within your strategy. So again, if you have a strategy and you set your min bid too low or too high, you know, there's a bunch of impressions or clicks that are not able to be served. It'll alert you. If your max bid is too low for an auction, it'll alert you. And it'll also tell you like the percent you're losing out because of that constraint. If it's a budget issue and you truly don't have the budget, you can know to ignore it and it's fine. But it's more of, again, a guidepost for you just to see in a perfect world how to get everything up to that perfect percentage. Here's what you would need to adjust. And then last but not least, ongoing maintenance. So like I said, once you have everything in place, revisit the items. Do they still make sense? Did you set these campaigns? Did you set it by campaign? Did you set it by keyword? How did you, you know, determine which keywords or campaigns or groupings went into each strategy? For those of you who have multiple strategies, the more granular will trump the higher. So if for some reason you have an impression share strategy on brand, but you have a few other, you know, it's at the rest of your strategies at the campaign level, that is fine. If you have a few set at the keyword level, those will trump the higher strategy. So that's general hierarchy. You shouldn't have too much overlap, but if you do, there is, you know, a hierarchy internally for the system to be able to figure out which one to adjust. But again, as you're evaluating, are the, you know, associations accurate? Once they're in place and the learning like phase has gone through, does the forecasting tool say your, you know, target is attainable? Does it think it could do better? that think it's too high. What are your, you know, it's going to give you those different evaluations and let you really consider your options. Another thing to look at is also just general impression share. That's a good metric to kind of gauge how you're ranking against landscape. So again, more of like a personal guidepost. So today we talked about, again, automation. So what do we believe the anticipated impacts and opportunities for your business live? First and foremost, like I mentioned before, it's a key objective and goal. We want you to have more time for the strategic decision-making process. Automation can help free up a lot of those manual hours. I can tell you from experience, being in platform, manually adjusting bids can take hours. Allowing the system to do it through a bid strategy saves up so much time. In theory, a lot of the algorithms are smarter than people. They don't have human error behind them. Things like rules, setting up rules seems small, but you know what? If your top campaign stops serving, it will save you so many headaches a couple of days later from not pinpointing it, because you'll just receive an email that says, hey, there's an alert, go check it out. So make sure that when you are using automation, you're using your time more valuably. So here's where the opportunity is. Figure out your strategic guideposts, start making some bigger decisions. As you're really expanding into automation, you'll likely see a pretty high gain in efficiency. So that'll allow you to really expand your keyword portfolio, scale more often, have higher visibility in non-brand, things like that. So there is usually an anticipated efficiency from automation. Leverage it to scale your account. In terms of evaluation, again, like I said, aspects like remarketing adjustments or device adjustments tended to be so manual. You'd have to go in and, you know, figure out what percentage each should be at any given time. If you opt into that function, then the strategies, they'll do it for you. Every 6 hours or four times a day, it'll evaluate every single device adjustment in your account. Talk about saving time, but also being super valuable. And last but not least, like I said, catching issues early. Something as small as, you know, campaign going dark, your budget going out, turning a campaign on or off, it can do it through rules. It can do it through automated aspects. So there are a lot of key wins for a minimal amount of effort. And finally, a few closing thoughts for you guys today. Bid strategies, like I mentioned, try setting them up in non-last click attribution modeling for the 99% of you on the line. In terms of strategies within SA360, so one of the enterprise level opportunities is that they can be multi-engine, with the exception of the keyword positional and impression share strategy. But besides that, you can run a tandem multi-engine Bing and Google strategy across a singular target, if you please. As a reminder, there is that learning phase for the algorithm. It is dependent on each account, but make sure that you are not setting it up right before peak season or when you expect you're gonna have to have a lot of manual changes. One, you're kind of hurting yourself because the system will not ever learn. And two, right before peak season, you know that you have different targets and values you have to meet. Allow the system time, either wait until after peak season or start it early enough in advance. Bid strategies can be created in a pause state. So if you were interested, you can set them up early, set them in pause. Basically, it'll start the initial learning process before you officially launch it. It does not eliminate the full learning phase. So unfortunately, it's not entirely out, but it can aid in the overall requirement time. So if you do choose to create them in a pause state, you'd set them up as normally would be. You just leave it as pause as actually enabling it. And then from there, it will not make any adjustments for you. It's just learning in the background. And then last but not least, like I said, average position is being deprecated for Google. So you have to run Google and Bing separately in terms of those two different models. Google will run the impression share strategy, and Bing and or other engines can run the keyword positional. But that will have to be taken and adjusted prior to August 15th. If your account team has not mentioned it to you, please reach out. I know I did send an email out to a laundry list of clients, so you probably received one for me. But if not, just make sure you're getting that discussion in place, because August 15th is unfortunately quickly approaching. But like I said, there's a lot of opportunity from automation, and so hopefully you guys are able to take some of those away. At this time, we'll open it up for questions. If you do have anything general, please feel free to leave it in the chat box. If you have something a little more account specific, you can also leave it here, and I'm more than happy to direct it to your client team. It looks like at this point there are no questions, which is totally fine. Again, if there are any questions later, please feel free to reach out to us. I really appreciate you all taking the time with me today to go through advanced automation. I'm hoping that you guys are enjoying the summer series, and we'll be reaching out for our August update soon. Thank you so much.